Hi all, thanks for tuning in. So this video is about some observations for maximizing solar power production, especially for portable applications. Let's take a brief look at PV basics. Starting with photons from the sun falling on the solar panel, triggering photovoltaic effect and generating electricity, which in turn charges a battery. However, some external factors can affect the power captured by the battery. Panel alignment, shading, temperature, cable length and gauge. Most portable solar panels use monocrystalline silicon cells. These are rated for around 23% conversion efficiency based on 1000 watt per meter square SDC or standard test conditions. Panel alignment is usually performed manually by a user. A portable machine that automatically aligns the panel optimally will soon be available. We're working on introducing our portable tracker for camping applications. Please sign up if you haven't already. So most panels come with bypass diodes, which lessens the partial shading problem. However, you may also run into complete shading when the wind tips over your solar panel. We have a product that solves this problem called SolarStakes, and it's available on Amazon. So bifacial solar panels, which basically exposes a solar cell on both the front and back side, can also help with maximizing solar power generation. Let's do some actual power tests and see the effect of redirecting extra photons onto the surfaces of a bifacial solar panel. The solar conditions today are okay for this experiment. There are high clouds and haze, which will prevent maximum output from these panels. I have two identical bifacial panels. These are prototypes of our upcoming production units. They both are producing around 70 watts when aligned towards the sun. So now I have placed one of the panels on a reflective tarp. This actually helps with two things. It redirects extra photons onto the solar cell surfaces and also helps suppress small shadows from grass blades. On the downside, the reflected sunlight causes higher solar cell temperature, and the reflective tarp can be problematic when it's windy, unless it's properly anchored to the ground. We will first note the power production from the bifacial panel, and then compare it to the power from the bifacial panel placed on the reflective tarp. As you can see, we get around 10% power boost from the reflective tarp. Please note that the overall power is still limited to the max panel capacity. So in this case, we can never exceed the 100 watt power number, regardless of solar intensity. Sometimes it may be necessary to place a power station a distance further than the cable length of a panel. In this case, you would typically use an MC4 extension cable. They're waterproof and readily available. However, poor quality cables can cause large power loss in transmission. Here, for example, I'm using a 10-meter AWG-14 cable that was included with a solar panel I purchased. It's definitely not high quality. Using this as an extension cable results in a whopping 10-watt power loss in transmission alone. It's best to use high-quality, suitable gauge like AWG-10 or 12 cable. And yes, I know, they can get expensive, but it pays off in the long run. The resistance of this cable measured with a multimeter is about half an ohm, which is about 10 times more than expected and explains the power loss. MC4 connectors are popular for extension cables, and Anderson pole connectors are often used to connect to a power station. I really like Anderson connectors as they can be easily reconfigured to reverse the polarity in the field. Just be careful removing the dowel pin if it's present. If you're using multiple cables, it's highly advisable to check polarity before connecting to the power station. Thank you for your time, and I would really appreciate it if you'd like this video and subscribe to our channel. See you next time.